David, thank you. A Bogotá teen is waiting to find out if she'll be expelled from school for bringing a pocket knife. A teacher found that knife when it fell out of the girl's book bag during a fight with a male student.
The girl says the boy was bullying her sister. Joseph Pleasant was with the girl and her family as she faced an expulsion hearing in Lincoln County. It's a story you'll only see on 16 WAPT News.
Tayshawn Rogers sits in the Lincoln County School headquarters in tears. The junior from Bogotá is facing expulsion.
It's really hard. I have never had no problem at school or nothing like that, and it's just not right.
Rogers had a pocket knife in her backpack, but she says she used it for fishing and forgot it was there. She says the knife fell out when a male student pushed her into a desk. Rogers says the boy was bullying her sister. She says she told the boy to stop, and that's when he attacked her.
It's hard, you know, because my daughter, it's stressful for her, and, you know, and she feels real bad about what happened.
Monday, the Lincoln County School Board held an expulsion hearing for Rogers. She and her mother had 10 minutes each to make their case.
Do you have two more that you want to send back?
Okay. Then the board allowed family members and members of the NAACP to address the board two at a time. The NAACP says other students have brought knives to school but weren't expelled.
Wait and talk to the superintendent. I'm not at liberty to discuss it.
We tried to talk to the superintendent about the NAACP's claims and Rogers' case, but the superintendent says student privacy rights prohibit him from commenting.
Do you have remorse for it?
Yes. I can't say nothing about it. I mean, it's done. I feel bad about it. You know, I apologize and everything, but no, things happen.
Rogers should know Tuesday if she will be expelled from school. As for the boy she had the scuffle with, Rogers says he was suspended, but is back in class. Reporting in Brookhaven, Joseph Pleasant, 16 WAPT News.
Rogers faces criminal charges in juvenile court. She's attending court-ordered anger management classes and must pay a $250 fine to the school district.